In this segment, I want to discuss my map tools and my map layers. Let's start with the map tools. The map tools, we have zoom in, zoom out, pan, we have back, and we have forward. There are several ways to zoom in, zoom out. Of course, you can click on zoom in. You can click left click once, and it will zoom in 25%. You can click on zoom out. You can click again left one time, and it will zoom out. You can click on pan, and while you're holding down the left click, you can move your map around to help center yourself. Back will take you back one zoom or zoom out. So if you zoom in too far and you want to go back to where you were and kind of start over, you can go back one or you can go forward one. You can only go back one space, so if you zoom in and you zoom in again and you want to go two spaces back, you can't do that. You can only go one space back. Also, if you use any tool, if you zoom in and you use, for instance, a draw down, and then you want to use back to zoom back, it won't do that. It will only take you back if you've just zoomed in or you just zoomed out. The same way with forward. Another way of zooming in, of course, is the plus and the minus here. In getting to my original area of interest, my favorite way is to go to the blue bar, click on the Zoom to Legal Description, populate the section, township, and range, click on Search, and it will take me then to that section. And I find this the easiest way to get to my area of interest. Once I get to my area of interest, then, of course, I have my different map layers. I can turn on my imagery, which will give me an image of the orthophotography that's been loaded for this county. Then I can also look at my contour lines. If I click on my contour, it will show me 2-foot contour lines. It is important to remember that these are 2-foot contour lines, and if you're used to looking at 10-foot contour lines, it can be a little bit overwhelming. There's also the layer, the terrain. If I click on the terrain, it gives me a black and light white layer. So it's almost a topographic map in shades of gray. What happens is in my vision here, it takes the lowest cell and it makes that black. It takes the highest cell in my view and it makes it white. And then every elevation in between is some level of a grayscale. The really nice thing is this helps me kind of identify some features. So if I want to draw my top of dam in from a high spot down through my draw and back to a high spot, this can help. But I think the place that this really helps is drawing in my watershed. So when I draw in my watershed, I can really kind of see where that top of the hill is, and it really makes that pop out for me and a little easier to identify. This terrain feature is especially nice in flat land where it's sometimes kind of hard to see where your water is running. And so I really like this feature. Now remember, in order to shut off the terrain and get back to your image, you do in fact have to shut off your terrain because your terrain always overrides your imagery. And so you can't just click on your imagery and see it. You have to actually turn off your terrain. Another nice feature about zooming in and zooming out, of course, is if you want to zoom in a little bit tighter, you can click on your zoom button, and as I said, you can left click and zoom in 25%, but another option is to hold down your left click button and draw a square, and then you can kind of fine tune how much you are zooming in or zooming out. And so there's really a lot of nice features. You can use the roller on your mouse to zoom in and out. I find this a little bit annoying because it really is very sensitive and one click takes you quite a ways. And so it's something that you certainly want to play with. And remember, if you zoom in or zoom out too far, you can always click on back or forward and get you back one step.